Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. It can be pretty scary to think of all the dangers of climate change. In the past, we've learned together why we should care, but today, let's find out how to be proactive about this situation. One way to help is to drive less when you can. Rather than using your own personal car, try to carpool or use public transportation. If your destination is close enough, maybe even consider walking or riding a bike. Carbon dioxide or CO2 is a major contributor to climate change, and vehicles are a large portion of the CO2 humanity produces. In fact, it's estimated that for every 2-mile car trip you take, 2 pounds of CO2 are put into the atmosphere. Please thank all those kids riding skateboards, because they're kind of saving the world. Even though they won't get off my lawn. You can also help out by recycling and reusing things when you can. Rather than throwing out all your gadgets and gizmos, see if you can find another use for them or donate them to charity if the product is still good. Recycling helps fight climate change because it takes less energy to make something from recycled products than starting from scratch. Also, consider buying things with less packaging in the first place, or items that use recyclable packaging. This next one might be a little scary to everyone who has ever taken part in the war for the thermostat, but I challenge you to try and let your homes be a little warmer in the summer and a little colder in the winter, even if it's just by a few degrees. Moving your thermostat up 2 degrees in the summer and down 2 degrees in the winter could eliminate an estimated 2,000 pounds of CO2 a year. And believe it or not, your diet can play a huge part in the climate change battle. Consider eating less meat when you can, as the animal agriculture industry emits a large amount of greenhouse gases. The livestock sector, which includes things like feed production and transport, is responsible for around 14% of all the greenhouse gas emissions around the globe. I'm not necessarily saying you need to go vegetarian or vegan, but maybe try things like Meatless Mondays or pick a plant-based option for even just one meal when you could have had meat. Every little bit helps. I know that kale salad looks scary, but you could do it. It should be noted, however, that it might not be as simple as all plants are better for the environment than all meats when taking everything into account, such as the energy required to produce the food. Overall, though, plant-based diets seem to be better for the fight against climate change than meat-based ones. Another thing you can do is inspire others to join the fight against climate change. This can be as simple as talking to your friends and family about the issues, or organizing groups and events in your local community. You can even contact your government officials and urge them to take action and have policies that lead to a healthier, greener future. And think about this, if you lose your world, well, then I kinda lose mine. I partnered up with an Inconvenient sequel to bring you this video because the stakes have never been higher when it comes to saving our planet. However, we are close to a real energy revolution, and you can take action and learn more by watching the film. Send a message of truth to power and see an Inconvenient sequel in New York and Los Angeles starting July 28th, and nationwide, August 4th. As always, I'm Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.